Oh, and look at this. I want to again show you my beautiful tomatoes. Look, the cow stepped on this one. But look at these big, beautiful, look, the cow knocked it off. See what the cows did? They're ruining my big, beautiful tomatoes. They're still green. Some people told me that these are watermelons, but I absolutely disagree with them. I think these are going to turn red, and these are beautiful, beautiful tomatoes. You see, well, unfortunately, the cows have been getting in my tomato patch. So you can see over there, they ate them, poor tomatoes. But some of them survived. Some of them are still on the vine. Well, this one's still on the vine. And we got more. Anyways, Steve, look over here what the cows did. You can see in here they ate all of the, they ate our poor little flower in our flower garden. And they ate, this was a, this was an entire fig tree. Now, will this grow back, Steve?
Yeah, it's still green. I'd put it away from them. So, yeah, it's still alive. It'll come back. See your buds coming out there. But definitely get it away from the cows. Himalayan mulberry and the Verte fig over there.
Now, what's the difference between a Himalayan mulberry and a Verte mulberry?
Oh, Verte fig.
Verte fig, I mean.
Well, the Himalayan mulberry is this real long, it's probably the longest mulberry we have so far. It goes up to 8 inches long. It's thin, it's purple, kind of like a raspberry flavor.
Are you sure these aren't tomatoes?
Positive. Although,
I think these are tomatoes.
That's fresh chew.
Let's look at some of the other trees we got from Exotica a little bit earlier over here. And see, again, one of the things I learned about Kin's Domains with, I heard the guy that translated it, Leonard, he translated it. I can't pronounce his last name real good. And he said, just start building your kin's domains. Get the problems out of the way, because every kin's community is going to have problems. And he referenced one problem. There was like this obsessive compulsive organic gardener. He was telling everybody how to build their gardens, and yet he never built his own.
Uh-oh.
Right, but that's part of the what you discover in the kin's domains. And that's one of the reasons we're in a rush to build this, because we want to make the mistakes. We want to plant the potatoes upside down. To show that even a city slicker can do this. Alright, but this is, I've got a solution for this, but I'll tell you later. You can see
they chewed on it.
Our problem. This is, what kind of tree is this now?
Apple. The Dorset Golden Apple, yeah. Minus and, some leaves. But.
And this was all organically grown? You use no chemical fertilizer?
Yeah.
Alright, and what's this one over here?
This one's a plum, the Santa Rosa. That's Luther Burbank's selection from the 20s.
Now, what my plan is, Steve, and tell me if this will work. I put these here, and wait, let's finish up. This is what kind of a?
It's a puat. It's a hybrid between a plum and an apricot combination. It's kind of a gold yellow when it's ripe. Very nice flavor to it.
And this one over here?
It's a nectarine, snow queen, white flesh nectarine, red skin.
And you can see that too. Now here's my plan. My plan is to plant them right where they are, extend this, make a redwood because of NorCal wood products, extend this deck out to just a little bit so you can walk out on your deck and you can pick your fruit. Will, are these grown, are these too close to each other, or will you think they'll be okay?
Maybe shift that over a little bit, slightly, but that'll be fine because then they'll grow together and you'll have shade. And because you can always prune plums and nectarines and peaches are easily pruned to form if you want to give it more of a compact shape. So if it gets too big, you can always prune the tips and force it to grow. But I mean, I even put sometimes two or three trees in one hole, so it's not so much spacing. They like to grow together. Plus you have deep soil here, it's just going to go down and take off.
Now, how big a hole do we dig and fill with topsoil?
Well, ideally, up to twice the size, or at least 50% bigger than the pot itself. This is a 15-gallon pot, which is 15 inches by about 14. So you might want to go down 2 feet down, and maybe up to 20 inches wide. And then you put your worm castings or compost or whatever organic material in with the native soil and mix that up. I also have some Peter's powder, which is a dried biodynamic compost, which you can mix in water to help inoculate the soil.
Yeah, they gave us a little thing of that when we bought these trees the other day. I actually drove all the way to Vista to buy these first group of trees, and then Steve brought the whole truck full for us. And And again, by the way, you want to, this video, by the way, is sponsored by Exotica, and you see what kind of trees he has. Tell us a little bit more for the people out there watching what you offer the public in terms of organically grown fruit trees. Mm-hmm. You know, something that they can get and where you deliver it to them, and where Vista is. A lot of people don't know where Vista is.
Oh yeah, Vista's inland from Oceanside off 78, Vista Village Drive. It's, well anyway, what we offer to the public is a lot of our plants. Well, not these ones in particular, but a lot of the pomegranates and figs. I grow a lot of things from seeds, and we have our own plant material and mother stock, and so we collect them and grow them. But what's neat about Exotica is we're right there. We're more in Southern California, so more of our majority of our plants is for the coastal strip. But also a portion of them are deciduous, so they can go in colder areas. But for example, on the pomegranates, we have 100 varieties. Becoming a big time crop in Central California and Europe. They're replacing the citrus with these because they're low maintenance, high in antioxidants, is good food, easy to grow.
And let me ask you a question while I've got you on camera. You know, if people come to Exotica to buy products who saw this, would you be willing to give them a discount if they have the Eco Harmony loyalty card?
Oh yeah, for sure, yeah.
Well, it's not a discount, it's a rebate. So the customer gets a rebate, and Patch Adams gets a rebate. Mm-hmm. And what size rebate? Oh, just, we won't hold you to it, we'll have a
10%, something like that. Or...
Okay, so a 10% rebate for anybody who goes to Exotica, who saw this video. And that will go, part of that goes to the consumer, and part of that goes to Patch Adams to help build a $50 million alternative healthcare, not alternative healthcare, a free hospital, which does use integrative medicine in West Virginia. So, Steve, I want to thank you for doing that. We'll get you all hooked up on that.
All right, one other thing. Besides plants, we offer information, soil care, how to make vitamin compost, where to get the preparations, and then also related material. Teaching about the earth, and my friend has a website called the Rosenkreutz Institute, and on there he has over 2,000 titles, and a portion of them are devoted to biodynamic agriculture and education, so it's a wonderful website.
What's the website again?
It's called the Rosenkreutz Institute, or THERKI Institute. It's a non-profit group, but he has over 2,000 titles, and some of them are the Rudolf Steiner translations by Rick Mansell, and I've given you a few of them. All about biodynamic agriculture and medicine and homeopathy, and for those people who want to delve deeper into what plants are about and how we can help heal ourselves, there's a lot of material covered in that website.
And I'm glad you mentioned that, because in KINS 102, KINS 103, and KINS 104, we will be having a very in-depth educational, free online educational stuff. For instance, one of the soundtracks he gave me today, what are those, DVDs or CDs?
Yes, both.
Okay, I listened to, and it said that roses will smell better if you plant them near garlic. Now, for the life of me, I'm a city slicker, I don't know how garlic makes roses smell better, but that's companion planting, biodynamic gardening, and those are the kind of things we're going to be teaching as well in the later courses of KINS 101. Right now, it's just how to build your KINS domain and how to make money and be self-sufficient. Again, Steve, in 3 years from now, how much food? Well, it looks like it's producing food now.
Yeah, that tree there in particular.
But 3-4 years from now, how many people can we feed from this collection?
Well, if you like mulberries, there's going to have 2 or 3 months of springtime in the mulberries. I mean, one tree is going to make 50, 100, 200 fruit. But see, as they get bigger, they can make thousands. I mean, some of my mulberry trees, for example, the Himalayan, it's about 40 feet tall, and it fruits for 3 months straight. You can eat them every day, a handful or two. So they, once they get their feet in the ground and get strong, then the tree becomes quite productive. So.
And for those of you that never had the pleasure of going to Exotica Nurseries, when you go there, you will see a cornucopia of fruits from all over the world on the tables that you can sample. Some of them taste like chocolate pudding. What was that one?
That's probably the black sapote, or the white sapote too. Oh yeah, whatever's in season we have all year round, because since our climate's so mild, we have sapotes, guavas, persimmons in the fall, mulberries in the spring, apples, plums, pears, pomegranates. The list just goes on and on. We even have mangoes and bananas too, so.
And I've had the pleasure of knowing Steve and going to Exotica for the last 12 years, since 1999. All right, so a little tad over 12 years. And I love the place, and it's, you know, and this is our first truckload out here. And as you know, on a kin's domain, you plant between 2,000 and 3,000 trees. Mm-hmm. So we'll be getting a lot of trees. You know, we'll have the Paulownia trees, you know, which is fast-growing tree, as the main living fence. But we're also going to do a different section of a main living fence. Here's bamboo. Here's Russian mulberry. Here's, you know, whatever works as a good windbreak. Mm-hmm. And so people, because remember, this is a model. We've got 4,500 acres on the other side over there, and this is just a kin's domain model, like any model of any house, except this happens to be a kin's domain. And as you could see in the other area, we've made the backyard look a lot better, mm-hmm. because we've planted sod. It's almost like a little park. And let's walk in there and see that you don't even know you're in the middle of a desert.
Oh, nice. See ya.
Well, you can already feel how what happens when you get trees together. All of a sudden, you got a coolness because the trees breathe. That's our relationship to the nature, is like they take our breath and turn it into their flesh, into their body, and they breathe out what gives us life. So.
Now, Steve, you just walked in here. Mm-hmm. All right, we're again, folks, we're in the middle of the desert. What's the difference in the degree of temperature between out there, 15, 20 feet away, and in here with grass and trees? And
it feels like at least 10 or 15 or maybe more. But it's more, you can feel the vapor in the air, the breath, the moisture. As out there, it's hot, penetrating sun, and here it's cool and gentle.
And what I tell people when I talk about kin's domains, we're actually creating a microclimate here. When you get the pond in, when the organic vegetable groves are growing, medicinal herbs, the grass where it's going to be, this will end up being its own microclimate. Mm-hmm. And it's, you know, you mentioned it, but it shocked me when I walked in here and felt a significant, you know, I would guess about 10 degrees difference inside here from outside there. And look around, folks, you would never think that this is the middle of the desert. So, Steve, it's been a pleasure to meet with you and getting educated from you. We're at the very beginning of our relationship with Steve, working interactive with us. And again, this video is sponsored by Exotica. And you can go see this wonderful nursery in Vista, California, and check the website. It's right down there. And it's Exotica, what is it again?
Exotica Refruit Nursery. And our phone number is 760-724-9093.
Repeat that one more time.
760-724-9093. Exotica Refruit Nursery. Been there 30 years. So that's why when you go in there, it's literally a jungle. You have 50-foot sapote trees and walnuts and everything imaginable on the ground there.
It's absolutely magnificent, folks. And once again, thank you for being here at Kin's 101. All right.